In this episode, I'm going to show you how to add some cool effects to your animation to give it a polished and professional look. This is part one in a two-part series, and in this tutorial, we'll be focusing on some text animation and using a shape layer as an alpha mat. This episode is also full of tips, tricks, and shortcuts that you may not have been aware of. Okay, so let's go ahead and create a new composition, and we want to make this 1920 by 1080, frame rate 2997, 10 seconds, and I'm just going to call this Cool Tricks. Hit OK. Command or Control Y to create a solid, and we're going to make this white and click OK. And now I've got some footage that I brought in. All the footage I'm using for this episode is from Envato Elements. So the first thing I'm going to do is bring in this aerial footage that I have, and as we can see, it's 4K, so bring up our scale by hitting S and make this 50%. Control or Command T to bring up your text. Okay, so I'm going to type aerial view and I want to make this white. Click on this snapping right here, then grab your pan around tool. I'm going to center my anchor point. As you can see, it just snaps right there to the middle. And actually, you can snap to any of these other nodes here, but I'm going to snap right here to the middle and then get your selector tool. You can do the same thing for position. One of the things that is important to keep in mind, if you only have one layer, it has nothing to snap to. So this text is actually snapping to the footage layer. So see, for example, if I turn off these other layers, notice now there's nothing for it to snap to. So I'm going to go ahead and get this back to the center there. I'm just going to move this text layer down here a little bit. So now make sure you don't have any of the layers selected and go up to our shape layer creation tool and just double click the rectangle tool to create a rectangle shape. And I'm going to open that up real quick. We don't really need the stroke, so I'm going to just remove that. And we'll be using this as a matte layer, so the color doesn't really matter. Just put a keyframe at the beginning of our animation and then shift page down twice to go for 20 frames. Put another keyframe so that way it's this 1920 by 1080 measurement. Let's go back to the first one and let's unconstrain our size and make this 1080 0. Right click on the second keyframe, keyframe assistant, easy ease. Go to our graph editor and pull these handles all the way over to the left. So that way it comes in fast and ends slow. Let's go to this aerial view footage here and let's just alpha matte shape layer one. So what we have is this opening up like that. So now let's go to our text here. I'm going to make this a little bit larger. Let's go to our effects and presets and type in typewriter. So just double click on typewriter. Now click U to bring up our keyframes. Close and then open back up this range selector so we get all of these settings here and then open up advanced. So let's change our based on from characters to words. And now see it's being animated with this start percentage here. So just click on the stopwatch to get rid of those. Click on the stopwatch again to create a keyframe and just scrub forward till we get a word. Now let's right click on this keyframe here and toggle it to a hold keyframe. Shift page down once to go for 10 frames and then just page down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to go forward another 5. And just make this 100%. So now what we have is the words come on one at a time, just like that. Close this up. Let's go forward to maybe about 2 seconds and 20 frames. Highlight these first three layers here and change the color to yellow. So with all of these layers selected, let's split this, bring everything up to the top, and let's go ahead and change this to an orange. Select our shape layer and get rid of that, and then turn off our aerial view text. And now we have the footage inside of our text. So if we watch it play back, we get something that looks kind of like this. Open up our text layer here, animate a position, and then we want to enable 3D characters. The way this is going to work is whatever value we set this position to is going to be where our text ends up. So let's just bring this back towards us. We want to move this up so that way our frame is filled with the footage. And now let's open up our advanced settings and change this from square to ramp down. Change our ease low to 100%. And I've gone over these settings before in other tutorials. So if some of this is unfamiliar, check out my other tutorials. I have a ton of them on text animators. Now I want to select this randomized order. We're going to turn that on. Since we're using ramp down, our range is going to be from negative 100% to 100%. Put a keyframe for negative 100%, shift page down twice to go for 20 frames, and then make this offset 100%. It's going to animate and come towards us like that. And now I just need to change out our aerial footage. So select the layer with our aerial footage and then go up to our project panel here. And I'm going to grab this skydiving footage and holding down Option or Alt, drag that on so that replaces it. And as you can see, this footage isn't quite as large as our other footage. So let's go ahead and make this 150 is going to be full screen. I'm going to kind of scrub through here a little bit to kind of get where I want my guy to be. So now if you alt left bracket, it will bring that layer's endpoint to where your playhead is. Let's watch that play back real quick, and this is what we have so far. And then it's going to animate towards us. And so now I need to put in some text behind this guy. So Command or Control T. One issue you may have, see, like if I just click in here and I start to type, it's selecting our aerial view text here. You can actually lock down these text layers here. So now you can create new text and it won't disturb the text you've already created. Okay, so I'm just going to type just jump. And then again, I want to make sure I've got my snapping on and my pan around tool. I'm going to center that, grab my selector tool, bring it to the center of my comp, bring up S for scale, and I'm just going to increase this a little bit like that. Okay, so I want this text to come in right after this other text animates on, so about right there. Alt left bracket, and then I'm going to add in another text animator to animate this in. So animate, enable 3D character, and then animate position. Then I also want to animate in an opacity. This value is now going to be our starting position. So let's make this Z value 2500, set our opacity to 0. Open up our range selector, and we want to set our ease load to 100%. We're going to change square this time to ramp up. And again, we also want to randomize this. And just as with ramp down, the offset was negative 100% to 100%. Same thing with ramp up, negative 100% will be our starting value. Shift page down twice, and now go up to 100%. So we have something that looks like that. Okay, so we've added in our text animation using text animators and started this cool little animation. In part two, we'll go over using the roto brush to put our skydiver in front of that text, and then we'll finish this animation off with some really cool tricks that will give your animation a film look. By strategically using some adjustment layers and making just a couple of tweaks, your animations will go from kinda cool to really amazing. Make sure to check back in next time to see the final result of this tutorial. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds and virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.